Random radio, random things that you should know. Thank you for being here with us. Make sure you guys hit that subscribe button so that you always know when we got brand new content. I am your host this week, Michael Jordan. You all, yes, NBA legend Michael Jordan, six-time champion, that's me. You all may have been watching my docuseries, The Last Dance, and it's been, thank you for watching it. I just wanted to tell you guys about some other basketball information that you may not have known about that you probably should know. So are you guys familiar with a thing called the Paralympics? It's the basketball Paralympics. Did you know about in 2000, the Summer Paralympics, where they had the big controversy with the team? Well, let's talk about that for a moment. In 2000, the Summer Paralympics in Sydney. By the way, you guys do know what the Paralympics is, right? Just in case we are unaware, the Paralympics is where athletes who have intellectual disabilities are allowed to participate in, you know, games for medals, you know, that actually count in the actual Olympics. All right, so just making sure that we're clear on that. All right, so here we go. The 2000 Summer Paralympics in Sydney, which had already been seen controversy with numerous positive drug tests, would be the venue for one of the most scandalous events in sports history. Spain was stripped of their intellectual disability basketball gold medal shortly after the games closed, after Carlos Ribagorda, a member of the victorious team and an undercover journalist, revealed to the Spanish business magazine Capital that most of the colleagues had not undergone medical tests to ensure that they had a disability.
In the Spanish basketball team that played in Sydney, there were 10 players who had no kind of disability, and only 2 players who were actually mentally disabled. At the beginning, I thought that it was totally impossible for someone to be capable of carrying out something like this. It just seemed completely incredible, and that was the reason why I got involved and joined the team.
The IPC investigated the claims and found that the required mental tests, which should have shown that competitors have an IQ of no more than 75, were not conducted by the Spanish Paralympic Committee. Ribagorda alleged that some Spanish participants in the table tennis, track and field, and swimming events were also not disabled, meaning that 5 medals had been won fraudulently. He went on to say that the Spanish Federation of Sports People with the Intellectually Disabilities deliberately chose to sign up athletes who were not intellectually disabled to win medals and gain more sponsorship. Fernando Martin Vicente, president of the FEDDI, the Federation of Sports People with Intellectual Disabilities, and vice president of the CPE, initially denied the allegations. After it was confirmed that 10 of the 12 competitors in the winning team were not disabled, Martin Vicente publicly apologized for the error and accepted total responsibility, resigning just weeks before the findings were officially released. 2 weeks later, the team was officially disqualified and was ordered to return the gold medals. Isn't that interesting? Check this out.
None of the players were tested, and after months of training, they arrived in Sydney in good shape. But they were too good. After beating the Russians in the final, they posed for a victorious team shot and were splashed all over the front page of Marca, the biggest paper in Spain. When some of the non-disabled players were recognized, panic spread through Spanish officials, and it was decided that the team would fly home in brilliant disguise. Carlos then ran the story in his magazine, and the repercussions were massive. The president of the Federation on Handicap Sports, Fernando Vicente, was forced to resign as the scale of the scam had now become clear.
How often do you guys think things like this have happened in the Paralympics, where people are supposed to be getting tested to see if they are having intellectual disabilities, and then they're not? And they're passing through the rankings, and they're getting through, and they're beating these other players. And what kind of a person do you need to be that you have to go out there? You're even okay with going out there and playing against these disabled players and beating them? There isn't one game that they said that they were beating the non-disabled, intellectually disabled people, were beating up the intellectually disabled people so bad by like 30 points at the half that they had to ease up on them because it was looking like, you know, maybe something you guys are beating them too much. That's disgraceful. That's disgusting. And who, what kind of a person do you have to be to say, yeah, I'm okay with this. I'm okay with us doing this to intellectually disabled people. Of all the people to do it to. I mean, I don't care. You know, look, race has no factor here at all. Gender doesn't mean anything. I have a soft spot in my heart for the intellectually disabled. I really do adore that demographic. And I feel as though this is terrible. 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 I'm glad to know that they got their medals taken. I'm glad to know that they got shamed. They were shamed in Spain. People were not happy about this. It was in all the newspapers. So I'm glad that that happened. But, you know, it's just disgusting to think that people would do this and think it's okay.
Since the scandal, the International Paralympic Federation have been unable to find an accurate test to confirm a player's mental disability. The tragic outcome is that thousands of athletes will be unable to compete at the Paralympics in 2008, all because of money.
Well, I don't know. You guys, tell me, what do you think? You leave some messages in the comments section. Tell me, what do you think? Do you think, oh, Lorenzo, you're just being too overly dramatic. That's not that big of a deal. That's not that big of a deal. Relax. Or do you feel like me? Wow, how disgusting do you have to be to cheat intellectually disabled people? How much of a loser, how much of a weak person do you have to be to cheat the intellectually disabled? Jesus Christ. Ah, disgusting. All right, you guys, leave a message in the comment section. Tell me, what do you think? Make sure you guys continue to watch my docuseries because, you know, it's a great docuseries right here. I haven't watched it. But anyway, make sure that you guys continue to watch it. And this is something that you needed to know. Random Radio.
Yeah, boy. You are listening to Random.